Thanks, little guy.
Drinking.
Oh, thank you.
Drinking.
Did I miss something? When did we get to Disneyland?
Ches pokutu ta krista krenko. Ya Oscar.
Yes, I bet you have.
Ches pokutu ta krista krenko. Ya Oscar.
Yes, I bet you have.
Hey guys, it's Stephanie. Welcome back to the Cantina. I am your Wookiee Wrangler, your chaos coordinator, your bar manager. Today I want to talk a little bit about a piece of news that just came up. I want to talk a little bit about the fact that a former accountant for Disney filed an SEC claim about funny money practices going on at the company. Her name is Sandra Cuba. And this is a pretty hardcore, in-your-face allegation. Basically, it talked about accounting software, basically money being juggled here to here. Let's put it this way. Back when Captain Marvel came out, people were going to the movie and, you know, seeing sold-out theaters no one showed up to. Okay, it's like, these theaters were all bought up. No one came. Okay, that's weird. My hairdresser, Lauren, if you're watching, hello. And her husband actually went to Endgame in Lancaster. And they had assumed at first that the theater was open and then two tickets opened up. So they bought them. Get there. No one showed up. Okay, there's all anecdotal evidence, but we've seen it before. We saw it with Solo, empty theaters everywhere. No one went. No one wanted to see Alden Ehrenreich's hair as Han Solo. I mean, that just ain't gonna do it, all right? Just stop it. So, you know, and then we got the bizarro notion that Captain Marvel made $1 billion. I'm not buying it. Look, here's the deal. I don't know anybody who went to see that movie. You know, maybe somebody did and I just haven't asked them. I do know that a lot of people who don't. No, I do. I do. Craig from Reviews for You went and said it was okay. It wasn't great. But it never got, the only buzz it had was the chaos surrounding its star, Brie Larson, who is a bitch. So, did it really make $1 billion? Let's think about that. What if, and I've seen this on Twitter, and it's kind of part of the whole, you know, kind of makes you think. What if The Lion King was making a lot of money? What if Disney re-put out Endgame? What if Endgame only made about 100,000 a day? Okay. I think it was during, can't remember what weekend it came out, but you know, it was making about 100,000 a day. And then suddenly it's ahead of Avatar. What if a lot of the money the Lion King had made went into the box office in a funny way towards Endgame? This is illegal. This is why, this lady filed an SEC claim. Now, the SEC gets thousands of claims like this every year. They have to investigate. However, with what we saw from the earnings statement coming back, with the movies barely breaking even, with Lucasfilm right now being a black hole of suck, and I think part of that is, to be honest, fans not understanding what they're doing and them not willing to really explain anything. And, you know, again, the mistreatment of the OT characters, you know, they depended on, I mean, and let's go further. Galaxy's Edge being a bomb, a failure. Rumor has it, and this is from Drunk3PO, that they're going to rebrand in 2 years Galaxy's Edge to reflect more of the original trilogy characters. I do believe Darth Vader is now wandering around free on Batuu at Disney World. So, I mean, who knows? But again, I'm going to leave the Deadline article in a pinned comment so you guys can read it, because it's really interesting to me. And with all the problems, and actually Disney's stock fell when this SEC complaint became public, which you guys got to understand, they have to investigate, all right? If there's any truth to this, there's a lot of people in trouble, a lot. And I'm not talking about movie execs. I'm talking about Disney bean counters. I'm talking about Bob Iger himself. I'm talking about maybe even Alan Horn, okay? You can't run a business like that, okay? You can't. And it's really sad in a way. I've said this before. The way the Disney Corporation has gone through so much. And, you know, even back in the day when J.R.R. Tolkien was still alive and Walt Disney kind of, I believe he actually made an appeal to buy the Lord of the Rings, the rights to make the movies. And Tolkien was like, no. Why? Didn't like him. Didn't like him because, well, among other reasons, he cheapened the stories. All right. There's something about that company that I think the greatest fantasy writer of all time was like, no. Okay. And it's too bad they got Lucasfilm, but here, what are you going to do about it? Anyway, so keep your eye on the news. If anything breaks on this, I will try to be one of the first people out with my feelings. I find it very interesting, considering all the stuff coming out about the earnings statement and the financials and how in debt Disney is. They're in a world of hurt. So, which is too bad. Again, it's too bad. And it doesn't have to be that way. Okay? There has to be some changes and reassurances to the customers. All right? Because if you mess with the money, if you mess with the box office, if you go out of your way to do something like that, the customers and the shareholders stop trusting you. Okay? So anyway, just out there with the news, just want to say hi. This is Steph sending out Sierra on the Galaxy, Sierra on the Cantina. Please remember, tip those Wookiee bartenders 20%. And no droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos, no Ray Nobodies, no Ray Palpatines, no Ray reincarnated of Anakin or Immaculate Conception Ray. Come on, Seagull, dude, stop it. No Ray, Luke's clone hand. Okay, none of that. That's just fanboys. Go back and watch the OT. And stop it. Okay, I know you're bored. No fights in the cantina. Take it out in the alley. Gunfights, you take this shit out in the street. See you on the Galaxy Scout.